हे गाइस, इट्स विशाल हियर बैक विद अनदर वीडियो। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट माय इनिशियल रिव्यू ऑफ स्लीपर क्लच विच आई हैव इंस्टॉल्ड इन माय बाइक। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो गाइस। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द वीडियो गाइज, लेट अस जस्ट एक्सप्लेन यू पीपल वॉट इज स्लीपर क्लच एंड वॉट आर द एडवांटेजेस। सो बेसिकली स्लीपर क्लच वॉज डेवलप्ड फॉर परफॉर्मेंस ओरिएंटेड मोटरसाइकिल्स, बट रिसेंटली द ट्रेंड इज लाइक एवरी 300 और 400 सी सी मोटरसाइकिल्स लाइक डोमिनर और KTM 390, सॉरी ड्यूक 390, दे ऑल आर हैविंग स्लीपर क्लच, एंड इवन अपाचे 200 4V एंड अपाचे 310, these bikes are also having sleeper clutch. When you are riding at high speeds and suddenly you encounter a sharp corner, the obvious reaction would be to slow down by applying the brakes and shifting in lower gears. But what if you have lesser time and you want to shift 2-3 gears at a time? And when you do this, you do it at the cost of damaging the gearbox and putting your safety at risk, which arises due to engine braking force. As a mechanism to reduce these issues, slipper clutch was introduced. So basically, slipper clutch helps by allowing the clutch to partially slip until the engine speed matches your own speed. So I have recorded some videos while riding, and you guys can see how slipper clutch is working, and in between I will explain you how my bike is behaving with this slipper clutch. So just this is the initial review guys, final review will come after 2-3 months maybe, once I will get all the advantages and disadvantages of this. So I have recorded two videos. One video is in complete straight road just to show whether the bike performance has decreased or increased. So as you can see guys, at the speed of 110 I downshifted from 5th gear to 4th gear, and I cannot notice any jerk in the bike. But if you do the same thing with normal clutch, then definitely your tire is going to get locked and you will lose the traction. But with the help of slipper clutch, as you can see, the RPM of the bike was raised, but the traction of the bike was stable, means the tire did not got locked, but the engine braking was increased. So here also you can see that I shifted from 5th gear to 4th gear at high speed, but I did not lose the traction and I did not feel any jerk. But as you can see, the RPM was increased and the braking was also increased, hence the engine braking has been increased guys. One more thing which I have noticed, which is a very good advantage, that is the clutch is very very light now, means you can press it with one finger also, this much, that much light it will become. So if you people want to install slipper clutch on your Apache 164V, then I have made a very detailed video on how to install it and which all parts you need. So please check the channel, you can see the video. Now let's go to the second part of this video, guys. Here what you can see is this is a very curvy road. The turns are very curved, very sharp turns are there. And what you can notice is I did not use my brakes while cornering. And you can see clearly that whenever I will take the turn, the RPM of the bike was increased. That means that I am not using my brakes. Simply I am doing one or two downshifting and I am taking that turn. And the main part of that slipper clutch is the wheel is not getting locked. That is the best part about slipper clutch. I have also made a video on all my bike modifications which I have done. So that video is also there in my channel, so make sure to watch that video also. I have modified my bike in a way that it will not look very very over modified. I have modified in a way so that all will like it and it is not over modification, as you can see. So now let's come to the discussion part. What is my opinion regarding the slipper clutch? So what I can say is, if you are not a hyper rider and you don't ride your bike at high speed, then basically this slipper clutch does not make any sense. So if you are a hyper rider and you want to ride your bike at high speed and taking very sharp corners at high speed, then this might help you. This can be one of the best options to include in your bike. So this is it for this video, guys. Make sure to subscribe the channel so that you will get updates whenever I will post any reviews. This is not my final review. My final review will come maybe after 2-3 months after using it for around 600 to 700 kilometers. So make sure to subscribe the channel, guys. It takes a lot of effort to make these kind of videos, and as you can see, the time on my speedometer is 4:30. It was very harsh sunlight, still I made these videos just for you people. So please support the channel, guys. Thank you for watching the video. Have a nice day.